Okay.
Good morning, everyone. This is Brian from the web, guys. And this is our In Conversation With. Thank you all for joining us. This is a pre-recorded, I have to say. Normally we go live on a Wednesday morning at 10 o'clock, but for various different reasons, this we just haven't been able to make it work for the live stream. So our guest today is Martin Woodbridge. Between him and myself, we're very busy people, so we've not been able to sort of tie both of us down at the same point. We've managed that now, so I'm very pleased to say that we got Martin with us today. Morning, Martin.
Good morning, Brian. Thank you for inviting me to your event. Yeah, I do apologize. Our schedules haven't been able to match, but we're together now, and this
It's a
will go out.
dynamic world. It's a dynamic world. That's just how it is, isn't it? So, obviously, normally when we do a live stream, you're able to post your questions to us live as we go along. So, what I'd like to suggest today is that if you do have any questions, please put them into the comments box, and both myself and Martin will monitor that, and we will do our very best to answer your questions in regard to today's topic. And we're going to be talking a bit about data today, Martin. This is obviously your area of expertise. So, how did you end up being an expert in data? How did that come about?
Yeah, very good question. Having spent 17 years living in the Philippines, overseeing call centers, training the staff, helping the call centers grow internationally and globally, going through the sales process, dealing with and handling data on a daily basis, with my call center staff, it was quite evident to me, that data is an essential part for any business to reach out to potential clients. But not only that, it's accurate data that the staff, the sales agents, business development managers, sales staff, they don't just need data, they need accurate data. Because the last thing that you want is to have a database where the information on there is inaccurate, out of date, and invalid. It's just going to make the job a lot harder for any sales staff, and it's going to make sales a bit more difficult to achieve there. So, having worked with call centers in the Philippines for over 15 years there, I wanted to come back to the UK. I was 6 months into the pandemic that I decided I want to go back to the UK, but what am I going to do? Didn't want to be in the call center industry. And it a light bulb moment in my head there. Businesses in the UK, or any business really, they need data. But they need accurate data. Not only that, they need affordable, accurate data. So I went about doing extensive due diligence and market research on the data market globally, and it's quite evident to me that businesses have had bad experiences with data providers globally, by buying out-of-date, invalid B2B databases at crazy prices. So I wanted to change that, and I wanted to offer a service where my clients' needs were the most important that I would focus on, providing them the most accurate, up-to-date, and valid and affordable databases available. And that's the story behind leadopedia.
Nice. That's very nice. I think that there's a lot of things in what you're saying then, and there's a few of them that resonates, with me. And I think for a lot of business owners, perhaps especially smaller business owners, that it's we all know that we need data, but it's not something there's a lot of information readily available how to get data. It's very much a market that seems cornered by some very big players. And when you go, because I can speak from experience here, when you go to some of those big name companies, then it doesn't seem very solid. You speak to someone who's quite clearly a salesperson, and you ask for something, but you're not really sure if you're getting what it is you're asking for, and you end up with this database that you sort of, I don't really know, but you sort of end up using it, and quite often the results are not great from them. So having someone who actually is a lot more personal, who can sort of hold your hand and guide you, because I think it's a thing that there's not a lot of knowledge in general around what it means to get data.
Yeah, absolutely right there. There's a number of big players in the data market globally, and obviously they've got sales staff, business development managers, and also a number of sales representatives. It's their job and their role to bring in new clients and sell them as much data as they possibly can. Irrespective of the quality of that data, the accuracy of that data, the cost of that data. And also, irrespective of focusing on the needs of the client, there is no personal touch. But with myself, having worked with multiple businesses across the UK in the last 12 months, I can say, and put my hand on my heart, that every client that I've brought on with leadopedia, I've made sure that the data that I provide them is the most accurate as possible. Not only that, understanding the data requirements. I want to know why do they need the data, how they're going to use the data, do they have experience in using databases previously, do they have a team in place that's going to help them use their database, what process are they going to be using, how many clients they need to see a return on their investment. So, really understanding the needs of my client, their data requirements, and also if they have any issues with that database, I'm here to assist them and fix any problems as quickly as I possibly can. Because at the end of the day, if I provide them data that is not the best, then they're not going to achieve the best results in sales for their business. And realistically speaking, they're probably not going to come back to do more business with me in the future either. So it's taking care of the client's needs, making sure that they have the best data at an affordable price so that they can see a return on their investment and potentially come back for more data in the
And that
future.
makes perfect sense because obviously you want them to sell from the data you provide them. So that makes perfect sense. I think there's a wrong expectations from a lot of us as well to see how much data do you actually need. It's easy to say, well, I need 50,000 records, but what does that actually mean? How are you going to handle 50,000 records? So the fact that you're guiding them, helping them, and holding their hands, I think that's really good. So if someone buys data, let's say someone buys 1,000 leads from you, how, because there's obviously only so much you can check the data before you supply it. What's the sort of bounce rate that someone should expect from any sort of data list they buy?
Well, a bounce rate and anything less than 10% would be a good bounce rate in that regards there. Some of our databases have an open rate of up to 65%,
Wow.
with some of our clients posting reviews on Trustpilot. We've got some great Trustpilot reviews out there. So some of our databases have an open rate of up to 65%.
Wow.
And not only that,
Can I just say that's not industry standard though, isn't it? I think
No, it's not that.
if people expect to send out a campaign and expect 60%,
No.
that is probably not going to happen for most people.
No, it's not. No. Anywhere between 10 and 20% should be a realistic open rate there.
No, there, I think that sounds plausible and very realistic. And again, I think it's one of them things, isn't it? Is that it's all well and good sending out a campaign to a large list, and if you do get a big open rate, which is obviously you want the biggest open rate you can get, how do you then handle that? So if you send out 1,000 emails in 1 week and let's say 600 people open and responds to that, how are you going to handle that? Because that's a lot of phone calls to get all of a sudden, isn't it?
Exactly. Yeah. So there's pros and cons to that kind of open rate, but we got some great Trustpilot reviews out there. Giving some positive feedback on leadopedia being the best data company they've worked with in the UK, with
Nice.
the best accurate data at the affordable prices. Not only that, complimenting me as well
Nice.
as the person that's overseeing the database process and transactions that, the service that I provide is second to none. So,
Yes.
it's good to get that feedback as well from my clients, because for me, it's essential that my clients do receive the best data that I can provide, and already that they see a return on their investment as well.
So, in terms of buying data, then we sort of talked about, the bounce and all that kind of stuff. What sort of a prices are we sort of talking of for 100 leads, 1,000 leads, 10,000? What sort of a cost are we looking at? What should people expect to budget for this kind of thing?
Yeah, so again, I've been doing having done research on data companies out there in the UK in regards to their prices. I believe that leadopedia is the most affordable data company in the UK. We're the only data company in the UK that provides a brand new GDPR compliant bespoke custom-made database for £99, and that will bring 250 data records, including LinkedIn profiles, delivered within 3 business days. For 1,000 data records, it would be £339, and for 5,000, it would be £1,499. Just to put into context as well, the day that the client receives their brand new database is the same day that everyone on that database receives a GDPR personal information notice email to inform them that their information has been legally sourced for marketing purposes. And they can opt out of that database. So whoever opts out is removed from the database. So as an example, there's between 5% and 10% that opt out of the database within 7 days, and they're removed. So for every database that I provide to a client, there's an additional 10% data on top
Okay,
included.
so
So if you,
account for the drop off. Okay, so if you bought 1,000, you would get 1,100
one,
too.
yeah, you would, yeah. So for example, if only 20 opted out of the 1,100, then you've got an additional 80 data records there, which potentially could bring in another client.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think that sounds so. You more or less answered my next question. It is the GDPR stuff. So basically, you contact every single one on the list just to make sure that they are happy for you to pass their details on to this company you're selling it to.
Yeah, and I believe there's no other data company out there in the UK that, number one, provides a brand new £99 database. Number two, sends out the GDPR personal information notice email on the day that the client re receives their database. Not only that, thirdly, removes the unsubscribed opt-outs immediately, and also includes an additional 10% data on top to cover any opt-outs of up to 10%. So for example, if a client ordered 5,000 data records, then they would actually receive 5,500.
Yeah.
So
No, that's very good. But that's very impressive. Absolutely. So is your services only available in the UK, or do you sell data all over the world? How does that work?
globally. So I have access to data globally, and I have a great data team as well that I work with. So any country, pretty much any country globally, if you're looking for data for, if data is available, then I can provide that. But also, the processor I work with my clients as well, understanding the data requirements and going away to see if that data is actually available. So
Yes.
to build that database. So if it's not available, which a number of instances I've actually had to turn down business, if you want to put it that way, where the data isn't available. So I'll also tell the potential client as well that I can't build your databases. There's not sufficient data available.
But that's a good thing, because that builds trust in you and in your processes, because it just shows that you're not willing to just sell any sort of duff data. So I think that's quite encouraging. It's good to know that you're selling around the world. We have quite an audience in the US, especially. So, for any US customers or potential customers out there who are interested in data, then Martin can supply you with data in the US as well. So that's good to know. That's wonderful, Martin. Now, as I said before, this is a pre-recorded. So if you have any questions about data and requirement data, how to use data in your specific location, then please put some comments in, and we will answer the best we can. Martin, I want to thank you for taking your time, finding your time in your busy schedule to have this chat with me. Thank you very much. All Martin's details is going to be below here. His website, connect with him on LinkedIn if you haven't done that already. And I know Martin is an avid networker as well. So if you're on a networking circuit, then make sure you say hi to Martin and have a chat with him, because I've known Martin for a little while now, and he's very good. He's a very big expert in his field. So thank you, Martin.
Yeah, you're very welcome. And yeah, it'd be great to read some of the questions and comments that you have. And myself and Brian will try and answer them as quickly as we possibly can. It's been great. And I wish you all a good Christmas and a prosperous new year there. Wishing you success in all your businesses out there.
That's wonderful. Thank you very much. And to everyone out there, thank you for watching In Conversation with us throughout the 2022. We got some very interesting speakers joining us in January, and a lot of interesting stuff happening. So have a Merry Christmas, everyone. Have a wonderful New Year's. Be careful. Look after yourself and your loved ones. And we shall see you all again in the New Year's.